the September 14th, 2020 meeting of the Maplewood Economic Development Authority. Ms. Sint, could you do the roll call, please?
Commissioner Smith?
Here.
Commissioner Abrams?
Here.
Commissioner Juniman?
Here.
Commissioner Neblett?
Present.
President Knudsen?
Here. Thank you. Before we approve the agenda, I think I had a call this afternoon to discuss some changes that need to occur. It seemed it would make sense that Executive Director Coleman or Assistant Executive Director Thompson could explain the change in the agenda. Could you go ahead, Ms. Coleman?
Sure. Thank you. Council member, or what is your title? President?
Yeah.
President Knudsen. Yes, this evening we will have a short presentation from Jeff Thompson talking about the tax increment financing and business subsidy agreement for the Maple Ridge Shopping Center. We had a public hearing scheduled for this evening. What we've had happen is we've had a little bit of a hiccup in our conversations with the property owner and with Hy-Vee, and there is still a point in the agreement that needs to be further discussed. The group that owns the property are in Canada, and we've been spending some time on the deal points that are in the packet this evening. We still need some more clarification from the property owner's perspective on the number of jobs that would be created through these agreements. We believe we have a commitment from Hy-Vee to provide the 100 jobs that are noted in the agreement, but the property owner is unclear about that. And unfortunately, our contact for Hy-Vee is out of, he's on vacation until Wednesday. So for that reason, we are going to suggest that we continue the public hearing and the action on the contract for private redevelopment with Suzo for Maple Ridge LP. But we are asking you to approve the resolution authorizing the interfund loan for advance of certain costs in connection with that TIF district. So with that, President Knudsen, I would suggest that you call on Mr. Thompson. He will go through a few slides just talking about the overall picture of those agreements. And then he has a schedule for you on one of the slides too, which will require us to call another special EDA meeting on September 28th at 6:30 to finalize these two agreements.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Coleman. I think what I'll do is go ahead and approve the agenda as amended. So do we have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Abrams.
Motion by Commissioner Abrams, seconded by Commissioner Smith. Any discussion? All those in favor? Commissioner Neblett?
Aye.
Commissioner Juniman?
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
And the president is aye as well. We have a motion to approve the minutes of August 24th, 2020 Economic Development Authority special meeting.
I move approval of those minutes. This is June.
Second. By Abrams.
Motion made by Commissioner Juniman, seconded by Commissioner Abrams. Any discussion? We'll call for the vote. Commissioner Neblett?
Abstain.
Commissioner Juniman?
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
And the president votes aye as well. Our next item that we discussed a moment ago should be, I guess, led by Assistant Executive Director Thompson. Mr. Thompson, are you ready to present?
Sorry about that. Can you hear me in now? Can you hear me?
Yes, fine.
Okay, I'm just going to start. And can you see my presentation?
Yes.
Okay. So thank you, Mr. President. Commissioners, as Ms. Coleman noted, we did want to provide an update to you on the tax increment financing application we've received from the property owner of Maple Ridge Center associated with the Hy-Vee project. And my last slide will outline the recommended actions we're proposing this evening to table the actual agreement, but authorize the interfund loan via a resolution. I did just want to provide the brief background that, again, this is a TIF application we've received from the property owner of Maple Ridge Center. It's associated with the Hy-Vee project, which the council and the EDA have reviewed a number of times over the past couple months. But in general, Hy-Vee is proposing a new grocery store in the vacant Rainbow Foods site, and then construction of a new freestanding gas station and convenience store. They are also proposing the potential of having a liquor store in the site, but that is not the subject or a requirement of the TIF agreement that's before you or included in your packet this evening. And as we've noted before, Hy-Vee would actually lease the space, and the property owner would retain ownership. That ownership is Sousseau Maple Ridge out of Toronto, Canada. This is the second step. So at your last meeting, you actually reviewed the first step in the TIF application, which was creating the TIF district and adopting the TIF plan. And ultimately, this is the second step or second phase of the TIF application, which does provide a draft agreement, which would determine the amount of financing being granted to the property owner for assistance with some of the public infrastructure improvements that are proposed on the project at both White Bear Avenue and Jarvis Avenue. Again, this is the action that the EDA has already taken, just showing when it adopted the TIF plan in August of this year. And again, that was just the first step in establishing the boundaries of the district, establishing the objective and policies, and the maximum budget. I just want to walk through briefly the higher points of the TIF agreement itself. Again, we're not asking tonight for approval of this. We will bring it back once the final terms of the business subsidy are agreed to, but we don't expect substantive changes to the terms of the TIF agreement. So under the draft agreement, the EDA would issue $500,000 in pay-as-you-go, a single $500,000 pay-as-you-go tax increment revenue note, and then pledge 90% of the increment generated by the project from the district to repay that note. And based on our estimates, it would take approximately 8.5 years to pay back the note issued by the EDA. The $500,000 would directly reimburse the property owner for the cost of constructing the public infrastructure improvements. So there are a number of private investments, private improvements happening on the property by Hy-Vee and the property owner. But again, what the EDA would be reimbursing for is the access changes on White Bear, this new signalized access on White Bear, as well as the access changes on Jarvis. The estimate from the property owner is that just the public infrastructure improvements are over $1 million. So the EDA would be contributing less than half of the cost for those public improvements. And then the other deal points of the TIF agreement is the property owner would be required to deliver a new Hy-Vee grocery store as an anchor tenant within the shopping center with a minimum investment of $5.3 million. We would also still require the construction of that convenience store and gas station because it is one of the components that we factored in for generation of the TIF revenue over the life of the district. And then obviously a requirement of the agreement is that they would have to construct the public infrastructure improvements to be eligible for that reimbursement. And they would need to commence that construction by December 31st of this year and complete that construction by December 31st of next year. Because the $500,000 is considered a business subsidy, so it is subject not only to the Minnesota State Statute on Business Subsidies, but also Maplewood's business subsidy policy. And as Ms. Coleman referenced, this is the part of the agreement that we are still working through the details with the property owner, but noting that the primary public purpose of this assistance are three things: removal of blight that's been identified in our analysis, increasing the tax base in the area and in the city, and then that third piece is the job creation purpose. So ultimately, the business subsidy agreement will codify the final number of full-time jobs that will be created for the project, and with a wage that's consistent with our business subsidy policy, which is $10.50 an hour. And then again, those preliminary deal points is the business must remain in operation for 5 years. And if they don't achieve any of the final goals that are put into the agreement, it could require a repayment of part or all of that subsidy. But again, as Ms. Coleman said, the final number of jobs, we will be negotiating that with the property owner and bringing that back to you at a future meeting. The last part, and this is what we are recommending approval of this evening, is the resolution for the inter-fund loan. The first increment payment on the district won't be received until 2022, and there will be some costs that the EDA will need to pay up front. So they will be eligible for reimbursement from the city's share of the 10% of the tax increment set aside for admin expenses. But we do need the EDA to adopt that resolution, which for the interfund loan from the EDA's general fund of up to $50,000 to pay those upfront costs. And again, those costs would either be reimbursed by the developer through their application fee or paid by the 10% increment for admin expenses. So commissioners, this is just the updated slide of what we're requesting this evening. The first is to not open the public hearing tonight, but to table the public hearing to September 28th, and also table the contract for private redevelopment with Suso for Maple Ridge to September 28th. And then we are requesting two actions of the EDA tonight. First is the motion to adopt the resolution for the interfund loan. And then lastly, we do not have an EDA meeting currently scheduled for the 28th, so we do need a motion to call for a special meeting on that date at 6:30. So with that, Mr. President, I know Jason Arsvold with Ehlers is also on the call, as well as Mr. Beatty, who's been drafting the agreement for the EDA, is here this evening. And any of the three of us can answer any questions you may have.
Mr. President, if you are speaking, it's possible you're still on mute.
Sorry about that. It wouldn't come down. Questions by the commissioners. We'll begin with Commissioner Neblett.
Sorry. No questions. Thank you.
Commissioner German.
Yes, thank you. I think obvious, but we probably should state it that we will still be attempting to process this loan motion tonight because the TIF district administration moves forward no matter what at this point, and there's going to be infrastructure improvements that rely on this getting moving. So that is why we are still doing interfund loan resolution this evening. Is that correct?
President and commissioners, that is correct. Mr. Beatty can also speak. I believe there's a 60-day deadline on that resolution. We're also trying to make sure we meet so that we are authorized to recoup those admin costs with that interfund resolution. So there's a bit of a timing issue with the resolution, as well as, yes, we are still incurring expenses on administration of the district.
Thank you.
Mr. President, this is Ron Beatty. If I could address that. Yeah, there are always startup costs for a district having to determine that the district qualifies as a redevelopment district. There's work that Ehlers has done. There's work that I've done, all of which will eventually be reimbursed through tax increment. But that's several years out. And so the typical way of doing it is to cover some of those costs through a deposit that's made by the applicant and some of it through an interfund loan. And so what you've got before you tonight is the EDA essentially borrowing from itself and with the intention that it will be repaid through increment with interest when that starts coming in 2022.
Thank you.
Commissioner Abrams, questions?
No, I thought that the materials in our packet and the description by Mr. Thompson were very clear. Thank you.
Commissioner Smith, any questions?
No questions for me.
And I have one. You know, in this discussion, it's kind of interesting when they talk about 100 full-time employees. I'm wondering if they recognize, or we recognize, that full-time equivalents were likely to be in the hundreds when you think of part-time people and all that. So I'm just wondering if a discussion with the, you know, the concerned party start to recognize that what we're looking for is a number of jobs. More of a comment than a question, I guess.
Sure.
Okay, thank you. Now we need a number of some motions. So
I will start with the first motion to table the public hearing for tonight.
Second.
Motion to table the public hearing for tonight made by Commissioner Abrams, seconded by Commissioner Gentleman. Any discussion? Let's go ahead and vote. Commissioner Neblett?
Aye.
Commissioner Gentleman?
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
President votes aye. So now we need another motion. At least
I move the tabling of the contract for private redevelopment with Suso 4 Maplewood LP.
Second.
Motion to table the development agreement by Commissioner Juneman, seconded by Commissioner Abrams. Any discussion?
Are you okay?
Let's go for the vote.
Oh, you are.
Commissioner Neblett?
Aye.
Commissioner Juneman?
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
And the president votes aye. Sorry for the interruption. My neighbor stuck his head in the door. Said, what are you up to? Sorry about that. Okay.
Meeting.
Moving along. We need a motion.
The motion to adopt the resolution authorizing interfund loan for advance of certain costs in connection with tax increment financing district number 1-14.
Second. Gotcha.
I didn't hear the second.
I said it first.
Okay.
Nobody's listening.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Oh.
Okay. Commissioners. Okay. We have a motion to adopt the resolution. Is there any discussion? If not, we'll vote. Commissioner Neblett.
Aye.
Commissioner Juneman?
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
And the president votes aye as well.
I move that we establish special meeting for Monday, September 28th at 6:30.
Second.
I didn't get the second again.
It was a choral response.
Can give it to Sylvia.
Oh, thanks.
Motion to hold special meeting September 28th, made by Commissioner Juneman, seconded by Commissioner Neblett. Any discussion? If not, let's vote. Commissioner Neblett?
Aye.
Commissioner Juneman?
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
President votes aye as well. Okay, there's no unfinished business, and we have new business. I believe that we're going to have Finance Director Paulseth. Are you available?
President Knutson, it appears that Ms. Paulseth is not available, so I will take the staff report.
Melinda, my apologies. She is not joined on the app. She has called in.
Oh, okay.
Available as a call-in. My apologies for the interruption. I will say, if anybody, we have a number of callers that have just called in, and I can allow you, I can unmute you. I'm sorry, I can allow you to speak, but you need to unmute yourselves by pressing star six. So if you press star six on your phone, Ellie, it would unmute you. City Manager Coleman, it still seems as if she's muted. I can try and work with her offline to get unmuted if you would like to.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and start the report, Mr. President, if that's okay.
That would be fine, Ms. Coleman.
Thank you. So President Knutson, members of the City Council, state law requires that cities certify their proposed property tax levies to the county auditor by September 30th. Once that's certified, the proposed levy can be reduced, but it cannot be increased. Our EDA bylaws require that the EDA also submit a budget annually to the City Council for consideration and incorporation into the city's annual budget and tax levy. So this evening, the total budget amount for the EDA is $150,000. And even though the city tax levy for the EDA is $100,000, there is residual carryover of existing funds through the ADA of $50,000, which may be spent if desired. The EDA can spend up to $150,000 without compromising fund balance, but it is not required to spend any of the amount at all. You have the authority to decide how the money will be spent during the year as the EDA. This is pretty straightforward. I will stand for questions, but if there aren't any questions, I'm requesting that the EDA consider the motion to adopt resolution in your packet to provide approval of the 2021 EDA budget in the amount of $150,000 with a funding request from the City Council for $100,000.
Are there any questions of Ms. Coleman? Commissioner Neblitz?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Juniman?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Abrams?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Smith?
No, thank you.
And I have done as well. So
I move to adopt a resolution providing approval of the 2021 preliminary EDA budget in the amount of $150,000 with a funding request of the City Council for $100,000.
Second by Abrams.
Motion made by Juniman, second by Abrams. Any discussion? Let's call for the vote. Commissioner Neblu.
Aye.
Commissioner Juniman.
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams?
Aye.
Commissioner Smith?
Aye.
And the president votes aye as well. The next item is approving the grant agreement with the YMCA. I believe that's also Ms. Paulseth, if not Executive Director Coleman. Could you proceed?
I am here if you can hear me.
Oh.
Yes, we can hear you, Ellie.
Oh, okay, great. Michael and I were muting and unmuting each other or something. So sorry about that. Thank you for the resolution. The next item was a resolution approving the grant agreement with the YMCA. So what the commission is being asked for tonight is to approve the CARES grant agreement that the city has made with the YMCA. What this does is allows the EDA to disperse the $800,000 in CARES Act funding to the EDA, from the EDA to the YMCA. $500,000 was for reimbursement of expenses for the YMCA's community response, and that included providing meals, providing welfare checks on senior citizens, child services, care services, a number of different things that they've provided for the community during the public health emergency. And $300,000 is for reopening and rehiring 30% of the furloughed employees back. They have met that goal, and have just are just slightly under the $300,000 amount for the wage or for the amount of wages for the time period, because the time period was pushed back to November 15th. But they have other expenses that are COVID related that they can apply that. And it's just a very small amount, a couple of thousand dollars. So that's why the grant agreement had one word added to it. It will be primarily spent on wages. So what we are asking of the commission tonight would be to adopt the resolution approving a grant agreement with the YMCA of the Greater Twin Cities.
Thank you, Ms. Paulsis. Are there questions? Commissioner Neblett?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Juneman?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Abrams?
No, thank you. The materials are very clear.
They are. Commissioner Smith?
No, thank you.
And I have none as well. So we need a resolution.
I move approval of the resolution approving the grant agreement with the YMCA, excuse me, in the amount of $800,000.
Seconded. I defer to Councilmember or Commissioner Niblett.
Okay. We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Hearing none, let's call for the vote. Commissioner Niblett.
Aye.
Commissioner Juneman.
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams.
Aye.
Commissioner Smith.
Aye.
And the president has no votes aye as well. So next on the agenda is resolution allocating CARES Act to St. John's. Who's going to discuss?
Thank you. I'm still available if that's all right.
Oh, yes. Go ahead. Please.
Thank you, President Knutson and commissioners. This final resolution is with regard to allocating the residual CARES Act funding. So the City Council declared $86,000 as residual when they made their allocation. And specifically in the counties of Hennepin and Ramsey, residual funds were to be sent to a major hospital within the county boundaries. That's specific to those counties. Other counties would have to return the money to the county. So the City Council is running, channeling this through the EDA for the same reasons that the city has other guidelines that they need to follow with regard to public purpose expenditures. And so that's why this grant as well is being channeled through the EDA, as the EDA has the authority to provide the business grant. So what we would be asking for tonight is a motion to adopt the resolution approving the distribution of the residual CARES Act funding to St. John's Hospital.
Thank you, Ms. Paulsis.
Okay. Any questions?
Commissioner Neblett?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Juneman?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Abrams?
No, thank you.
Commissioner Smith?
None for me, thank you.
And none for me as well.
I move approval of the resolution approving the distribution of residual CARES Act funding in the amount of $86,000 to St. John's Hospital.
Second.
Motion made by Commissioner Juneman, seconded by Commissioner Abrams. Did I get that right? Mm-hmm. Any discussion?
Yes.
If not, let's call for the vote. Commissioner Neblett.
Aye.
Commissioner Juneman.
Aye.
Commissioner Abrams.
Aye.
Commissioner Smith.
Aye.
And President Knutson votes aye as well. That finishes our business for this evening. Is there anything else to come before the Economic Development Authority? If not, we stand adjourned and we'll join the City Council meeting at 7:00.